Oh, okay. Thanks, Elaine. Okay. So we're here today to talk about postgraduate life. My name is Athanasia, and I'm currently a second-year PhD student at the University of Edinburgh. Specifically, I am working at the IGMM, which is where the Western General Hospital is located. It's basically an institute where it hosts the Cancer Research Centre in Edinburgh. And my project is relevant to brain cancer, specifically glioblastoma. And therefore, I am doing my project over there. I am specifically under the program of precision medicine, and I think the most benefited feature from that program would be the fact that we do have teaching as well. So you indeed get to gain sort of new skills after sort of completing the PhD. Well, my project now. Well, my project is specifically about a group of proteins and how they tend to move within the cells in brain cancer. These are called adhesion proteins, and that might sound a little bit complicated, but I use a specific technique which is called mass spectrometry, and well, I'm trying to identify where those proteins sort of go and how they move. So basically, this is what my project is about, and my supervisor is Adam Byron, and we are under the lab of Margaret Frame. I guess I'm here to sort of respond to perhaps questions that people might have that are thinking of doing a PhD. I've also done my master's in Edinburgh, therefore I could give an opinion about that. So I did my master's like 2 years ago. I did the biomedical science, which at the time it was consisted of two different projects, like 2 6-month projects, and you had the freedom to choose which project you wanted to do, at what building, at what lab, and then of course you just had to go talk with supervisors and, you know, just make the best decision depending on what you'd like to do in the future. I did a 6-month computational project, and then I did my second project in colorectal cancer in a lab quite close to mine now, just a few benches away, really, even at the same floor in the AGMM. So, yeah, that was very, very, very briefly my experience, and please do ask if you have any sort of questions. I think I can see questions here. Okay, so someone asked, what is it like to be a PhD student? So I guess that's a different response from every single person, but for me, to do a PhD was something I really, really wanted, but then when I sort of met my actual project, it was not an idea anymore. I was just thinking, I really want to do this project. I really want to sort of get this knowledge. So it's something that you really need to be committed and make sure you really do want this to do it. And it's really, really fun. And honestly, I think you get so many skills, and I'm not just talking about you know, learning new techniques, because okay, that's probably the easiest one for every single person to think. Of course, you're going to get to learn new techniques, but it's also that within these 3-4 years, you will get to network and meet so many people that could determine your future. And then it's about how you do your own self-development. So there is a lot of things that you do gain at the end of it that you were not even thinking of before doing a PhD. Long story short, just go for a project you really, really love and you think you will stay committed. Another question. Do we need to have a doctoral degree to pursue a PhD? I'm not sure what you mean by a doctoral degree. If you mean like a degree in medicine, then no, because I did my undergrad in England and I graduated as a biomolecular scientist. Well, my degree was biomolecular science. And then I did a master's by research, which is, let's say, the most recommended thing to do if you want to do a PhD, because it is a good taster. It does give you a taste of what a PhD feels like, because it's not that you just have taught courses. It's a bit more independent. You have to actually sit down, do reports, and do all the things that you would do as a PhD student. So I don't think you need to have a doctoral degree. No, you can do it even if you're a biologist. There is even in engineering. Many people do PhDs in maths. And I think there, even in philosophy, like there are lots of PhDs. And so don't ever like be shy to just drop an email to any sort of admissions or any supervisor. They will honestly be quite happy to answer questions if they see a student that is interested. That's what they want, to see the interested candidates. I think that's it. Okay, more questions. How do you manage stress? I guess not just PhD, but even undergraduate and masters, both taught and research ones, they cause some stress because, okay, you really want to do well, right? You don't want to stay behind, you don't want to fail anything and stuff, so there is always some stress. However, I think that personally how I manage stress would be to have a balanced routine and sort of have, some time for myself as well. So it's not healthy if you work for day, night without having some time for self-development. Also, some people do need to be creative, and some others are way better off doing some sports, for example. So the routine, having a routine, is very important both for keeping and maintaining your PhD like in place, so having set deadlines and everything, and also sort of maintain your life in a balance. Basically, that's just it, balance. And also another very important thing, when I feel stressed, I talk to my supervisor. Adam is a great supervisor. He's quite understanding. And this year I had several sort of stresses, especially with the pandemic. You know, I was thinking, is that going to harm my project? And many, many questions causing me stress. But Adam was always there for me. And this is indeed something that the supervisor needs to do. He should be by your side and he should be supporting you. And more questions. Are you planning on working in academia or industry at the end of your studies? So, of course, it is a bit early to say specifically that I will do this or that. But what I really, really, really want to do after I finish my PhD would be to move in a foreign country and try and do a postdoctoral. I think that after your PhD you can certainly apply for an industry because you have achieved a quite a, you know, large qualification, and in industry most of the times they do want people who have PhDs or have specific experience on a topic. But yeah, personally I really want to do a postdoc. Haven't thought of specifically my career plan till the very end because things are changing, but industry is not on my immediate plans. I really want to do a postdoc and stay in academia for a while, and I guess that's my answer to that. Okay, some more questions. Is it difficult to balance work and life as a PhD student? So at times there are some more stressful times and there are some more easygoing times. I think one of the most sort of not balanced times for me was when I was away in Sweden, because my PhD is split into places. So it's half in Karolinska Institute in Stockholm and the other half is in Edinburgh. And I had to do an assignment in mathematical modeling, and I was already in another course that was taking place in Sweden, and you know, that was not very balanced because I had to do two different things taking place at the same time. Therefore, it was a bit hard to do. Yeah, as I said before, having a routine and have a balance, take time for yourself, take time to not just, you know, do extracurricular activities, but also socialize, go to the gym, and in general, you know, keep yourself healthy. I think that as long as you do that and keep balance, you will be fine. How often do you meet with supervisors? Okay, so I have four supervisors. I know it might sound strange, but precision medicine tends to give to students sort of many supervisors. My main supervisor for the first and second year is Adam, who you know, designed basically the project. But then I have another supervisor in the Karolinska, so that's in Stockholm, as I said. And then my other two supervisors are there because they are specialized on a sort of specific topic. So for example, data analysis is a very important part of my project, but that takes place after I have obtained my data, so sort of third year. So my third supervisor is going to work quite closely with me at that time much more. But I do meet my main supervisor, Adam, every single week, and I make sure I have a report of my activities, everything I've done on the week, just to keep track of how well I do and what do we need to do, what else fits the project, especially during pandemic, but all projects need to be adapted. Yeah, and also we have the lab meetings that we do with the whole lab. So as I said, I'm in Margaret Frame's lab, so therefore we're like, what, perhaps 20 people, maybe more just now. But yeah, I do meet them as well every single week. Well, for now it's Zoom meetings, but before we used to all come in the same room and have a presentation from a member of the lab each week. Okay, are you a member of any postgrad societies? No, I haven't joined any postgrad societies, but I have been doing since my master's the maths outreach, so I'm quite interested in sort of outreach activities, and therefore I joined the outreach team because I really loved the concept of making children love maths, and it depends on you how much involved you want to be with that. And I really wanted to be involved, so I spent a lot of time on this particular activity. And I've also done lacrosse for a while. I've done like for one semester, mainly because the weather was quite good, and I was feeling like when it's getting quite dark, I didn't really feel like going for sports. But it was a great experience, even for a short time. Yeah, it was great. I totally recommend joining societies and try things. Honestly, just go and try, even if this is like something that needs to be auditioned or tryouts, whatever. You should go ahead and give it a go, because you know, you only live once. Okay, last question. How you correspond with your supervisor first? I'm not sure I understand this. I guess, what you might mean. So the supervisor is actually there to advise you about the best things you need to do, both for your project and your personal development, you know, as a sort of student, because they want you to succeed and they want you to sort of have obtained your purposes at the end of your PhD. Therefore, they are indeed there for absolutely anything, and I think these are the best people to advise. Also, other peers, so like other PhD students that you're perhaps in the same cohort or something like that, would be good advisors as well. But yeah, the supervisor is really, really important to know how things are going for you, if you have any worries about your project, if you feel that something is not working, if you want to go, let's say, and do training, like the one I wanted to go and do in Sweden. I talked to my supervisor and he was more than happy for me to go in Stockholm and take that mass spectrometry training. So yeah, they're actually there for absolutely everything, to be honest. I think that was all in terms of questions. I don't see any new comments coming in, so if you have a question, you can just drop it down here. I'll read it. Otherwise, if you don't want to do this, if you want to think of it, or if you have any sort of additional questions, you can sort of type them in the story. I'll keep responding through the stories then, for the rest of the day. And I think that's all from me. So yeah, thank you very much for being here, for attending this way. I really hope one of the perhaps following years this could be live, as we did the past years. You know, it's much more nicer to interact with people when you're in the same room, like get lunch together and, you know, just chat about things. And yeah, of course, you should be searching about like anything in terms of postgraduate. I understand how people have questions about these things and how some things are sort of stressing, but don't worry about it. It is a great experience, it is a journey, and there is so much both life benefit and also benefit as a student. Is a great thing to do. Yeah, I think that's all. So okay, thank you very much for being here, and that's me. I'm gonna end the live now. Bye.